Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Ordinary Data Scientist, where we talk about data science.
So friends, before watching this video, I assume that you had already gone through the previous video where we discussed some of the concepts like percentile, mean, median, modes, how to get the percentile using this three steps formula and all. Okay, so if you haven't watched the video, I'll request that please go through the video first and then watch this video. Okay, so quartiles, what is quartile? Now quartile, if you remember the example from percentile, where we had the number axis and we divided the number axis into 100 smaller chunks, right? 100 smaller chunks, right? Where we can calculate, literally calculate anything like 65 percentile, 75 percentile and all. Quartiles is a special case of percentile only. Instead of having each percentile, we will have just standard one like 25, 70, 50 and 75. Yeah, so we'll divide the number line into four smaller chunks now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and each chunk you can say quantile. So we say that this is first quantile, second, third, fourth, we can say that. Okay, now this data points you see here, this data point, this data point, this data point are called quartiles. So this is called q1, q2 and q3. Yeah, these are quartile. So you can see the definition here also. Now if you have any number array, you can quickly calculate each quartiles, right? So for example, this array, if I need to calculate, let's say q1, which will be your 25th percentile, right? So the number are in ascending order, so that's great. Now q1, for finding q1, it's nothing but, as we remember the formula, I is equal to your p divided by 100 into your n. So literally, if you need to understand this formula, is just that the nth percentage of something, like you have, let's say we have 20% of x. So how do we write? We write x into 20 divided by 100. Similarly, if you have p percentage of n, it will be nothing but a p into n divided by 100 only. Okay, now here we will find 25 divided by 100 into your 448, and this is nothing but your 2. Now I is a whole number, so this will be the average of second and third data points, right? Second and third. So second is your 109 and third is your 114. So you take the average of this and you find a data point here, and that you call q1, which is 111.5. similarly for q2, it will be 50 here, you know, 50 here, and then you just update the formula, 50 here, so it will be like 4. So that means q2 will be your average of fourth and fifth data point. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 data points. So here, somewhere here, it will be q2, fourth and fifth data point, 106, 121, so that's 118.5. similarly, you can calculate q3 also with 75 percentile, and the numbers will be somewhere 123.5 here somewhere, q3. Easy. So again, as I said, the in percentile we can literally calculate all the percentile, like 10 20 30 40, something like that. In quartiles we just have three data points, q1, q2, q3. Okay, and q2, if you see people, q2 is the special case of your median only. Yeah, so you can take a note of that. So here we calculate the quartiles. Now let's take a quick example here, and it's some marketing categories, and then it says that can you find the first, second and third quartiles. So here we can calculate everything, like your first percentile will be 25, 50 and your 75. We can calculate the data is in descending order. So somewhere here will be 25, then here will be 50, then here will be 75. That's the only difference or only thing that you should worry or care about, that you know if the data is in descending order, so you have to go from bottom, not like top. The 25 percentile won't be here, like not like this. Okay, you have to go from bottom. So you can find that like Q1 is 4 plus 5, so 1 2 3 4 4 plus 5 divided by 2, so Q1 is somewhere here, similarly Q2 and Q4. Okay, so always remember people that Q1, Q2, Q3, you go from mean to max. So mean to max, so from here 25 50, and so on and so forth. Okay, mean to max. So if data is in descending order, you will go from bottom to top. If it is ascending, you will go from top to down. Okay, cool. Now let's quickly cover two more concepts, and then we'll move to the second part of this chapter. So the other topic that I want to cover is range. What is range? So people, if you remember the Google example, the minimum salary was 2 lakh and the maximum salary was 56 lakhs, right? So if you calculate the range, it's very, very high, right? Like 54 lakhs, 56 minus 2, 54 lakhs is the range. Now, when you understand the range, you can literally find that this is a huge, huge gap, you know, in terms of the salary distribution. So you can write that range is nothing but your max minus mean. Okay, that's a example. Now take example of you are a producer of a cricket bat, and the bat should be 4 kg. That's the standards measure that you had given to the contractor. Now contractor produces the bat, the cricket bat, but sometimes it can be 4.1 kg. And sometimes it can be 3.9 kg also. Now you had given the optimum weight, but will you accept this bat? Probably yes. Yeah, you can have the 10% error. You can consider those bat. But if some bat is 4.5 kg and few bat is 3.5 kg, you might not accept those bats. Right, because these are way beyond than your acceptance range. So the when we say range, it means the max and mean, and any product which are falling under this range can be accepted. Now let's quickly understand interquartile range. Now people, if you remember, we discussed the quartile just few minutes back, that it is nothing but the special type of percentile only, but instead of 100 we'll have only 3 data points, right? We discussed that, like Q1, Q2, Q3. Okay, now interquartile is another special case where we will just focus on this particular region only. That means if you have your Q1, Q2 and Q3, we'll just worry about your this range, Q3 minus Q1. If you see the example of Google, you know, here you see 25 75, which is nothing but your Q1 and Q3, and this is the range that we should worry about, because the maximum population, almost 50% population falling under this range, remaining 25 here and remaining 25 here, but 50% population are falling under this range. So this is called your interquartile, right? Interquartile range, Q3 minus Q1. So people, I think very interesting concepts that we just read about, the percentile, the quantiles, interquartiles, range, mean, median, modes and all. So please try to go through the concepts once again, revise them and try to solve few examples which will help us to build a strong understanding of the concepts, okay? We'll definitely use these concepts in our data science, like during the outlier treatment, when we perform some ED on the data, we'll do this kind of analysis, and also when we try to build some regression model or something, we'll check mean, median, mode, those concepts we'll also check there, okay? So with that, I'll take a pause here. Please revise the concept and I'll see you in the next video.